The shame is not ours to hold. The shame is on the perpetrator. Me Too can be a conversation starter, or it can be the whole conversation.
Long before it became a viral hashtag, Tarana Burke sparked the global Me Too movement, which is aimed at stopping sexual harassment and assault. She's the founder and executive director of Me Too International. She is an activist. She is an author. And today, we are honoring how she has blazed trails and facilitated healing as living Black history. Tarana, thank you so much for being with us. You have dedicated your life to helping sex abuse survivors. You've been doing this work for decades, way before it was a hashtag. And we all know that you yourself are a survivor of this. What's it been like for you to have this type of impact and, you know, really still at a very young age in this work? You've been at the forefront of Me Too even before it went viral.
Well, it feels great to have an impact that I never thought I would on this stage, right? My work was community work, and I intended to do that really for the rest of my life. It's what I call my assignment. In the middle of my life, really, right, to have an opportunity to scale up my work to this degree is, I think, every organizer's dream come true. To impact more people, to have a bigger voice, a bigger platform. So it feels surreal sometimes, even with the challenges.
Yeah. Well, you know, the work that you do, as you say, Tarana, you know, it is organizational work. It is grassroots at its origin and at its core. So a lot of people only see, you know, you on the big platforms, all the news headlines, and of course the social media. Tell us a little bit about what your actual organization does on a day-to-day basis.
Well, thank you for asking that, because I think we get conflated with so many other things all the time. But we are a Black women-run organization. Our entire executive staff is Black women. And at our core, we serve Black and brown people in the most marginalized groups, although, you know, that's not to the exclusion of anybody. We do what we call digital direct service. We have resources that, quite frankly, I couldn't find for survivors that I was serving. Back when I was doing this work, we have a website that sees almost 2,000 survivors daily with resources that are culturally competent for folks from all walks of life. We have a program called Survivor Leadership Training. We have Survivor Sanctuary, which I think is really our gem. It is a digital service where survivors can go on our website and craft their own healing journey. We have 36 videos that you can watch at your own pace, craft any way you want, and we're continuously adding to those resources. We also do narrative work, because the truth is people don't understand what sexual violence is. They don't understand survivor justice. And so because we are a small organization with a big name, we're tasked with helping people to understand exactly what Me Too is, what the movement is, and what survivor justice looks like.
Indeed. And, you know, a lot of what you described there, Tarana, it's not lost on just me personally. I serve on the board of directors for Safe Horizon. So that nitty gritty work, reframing, healing, just having communal support when you talk about your experiences as a survivor. I just don't think it could be overstated how grateful we are as a culture for you leading that work, especially amongst Black women. The phrase Me Too started, you started kind of talking about it around 2006. A decade later, it becomes this national, global phenomenon. Can you talk a little bit about what that process has been like for you personally?
It's had its ups and downs. You know, like I said, I'm really grateful to have the platform. I'm really grateful to have, you know, to be able to serve more people and to sit in this position. And it's been a challenge to see people, to get people to see that this is an issue that is really a public health crisis, to get people to understand that this is a moment where we have to look beyond the hashtag and see this as something that is affecting us every day. Every 68 seconds in this country, somebody's affected by sexual violence. So it's bigger than just seeing me on television. It's bigger than just some court cases that you see roll out in the media. This is about people in your community. This is about your cousins and your aunties and your coworkers and you, right? And I think that because of the hashtag, it's been made into more of a spectacle than a social justice issue. And this really is a social justice issue.
I love that framing, Tarana, of it being, you know, it's a public health crisis. And I think that framing kind of presents the gravity of it. Talking about moving beyond the hashtag, you yourself entering the scripted and the non-scripted television space, how will that storytelling advance this work?
You know what I realized when I got this platform is that one person, I could run across this country making speeches all I wanted to, but one person can only do but so much. So when I got the opportunity to tell stories on a big screen and television and in movies and things like that, I really jumped on it, not just to tell the stories around sexual violence, but to tell bigger stories about Black women, about queer people, about marginalized people, just about people that we don't see, because I really don't think that we're going to see the kind of change we want to see in our lifetime unless the narrative around who we are as human beings shift, right? What does the interior of our humanity actually look like, feel like? And so that's why I want to tell stories, because I think there's more work to be done. And the stories we've been told do not tell the fullness of who we are.
Yeah, I just got to tell you before we go, Tarana, that what you have done by way of visually and vocally centering Black women in a movement that was but this close, in my opinion, of being hijacked by white-centeredness, which is usually the case for us here in America, it's tremendous. It's courageous, and it is invaluable. Tarana Burke, I want to thank you for everything that you do for us in the culture. It's so, so important.
Thank you, sis. I appreciate that.
Absolutely. Now, coming up, you know her as the voice of Penny Pratt from The Proud Family, Miss Kyla Pratt. She sits down with Panama Jackson for his Dear the Culture podcast. It's up next on The Grio. Stay with us.